That's reading a 74 on the Manticore. Thud, 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 thud. Come on, beer coin. Look at this coming out of here.
Here's a good boy.
Massive, great, silver coloured disc. Hello and welcome to Found in the Ground. I am out today in South Norfolk, beautiful sunny day in a really Saxon rich area, and I'm out to try and find some lovely history in the ground. My first find of the day, pop a little bit of iron earlier, which we won't speak about, is a button. Here we go, it's probably Victorian. It's a pewter button, quite large, no shank on the back, but it's a start. I'm on this pasture, which has seen quite a fair bit of rain recently, to be honest, so it's not too hard to dig. But there's been Saxon come up in this area many, many times, so I'm feeling really, really positive today could be the day I get my first Saxon coin. Right, let's stop talking and see what we can find in the ground. Monster clod. Look at that beast. Came out in a wanna. Yeah, I think this is a piece of sort of window furniture. Yeah, something like that. Boom. Had a scruffy little signal down here on the metal detector. It wasn't the most obvious, but it was fairly consistent backwards and forwards, which is what you're sort of looking for. You really want that consistency of signal. And it sort of broke apart a little bit as I was taking it out, and I thought, oh no, I've absolutely smashed this up and destroyed it. But it seems to be a button that was underneath another piece of metal. As you can see, would have been maybe a bigger element over the top of the main part of the button. Maybe something quite fancy, because it looks almost shiny under all that rubbish there. But there we go, that's number two button for the day. At least I'm finding, I'm out there and I'm finding. However, that button was probably getting on for sort of 2/3 of a foot deep, and that's maybe a couple hundred years old at best. So any real ancient stuff's gonna have gone much, much deeper, unless something sort of changes within the landscape. Maybe some more rocks or whatever. Can't give up hope yet. Just dug this clod, you can have a little listen. Thud, 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 dull signal. This is reading 1213 on the Manticore, which is very, very low, and the tones go all the way up to 100. And I can see straight away down in the hole, it's at least what we should be digging. But it's a pinfire shotgun, an old thing. There's bits of green falling out all over the place. So these were the sort of the shotgun cartridges that preceded the more standard ones with the percussion caps. So this pin on top was pushed down and created a boom. So yeah, it's a piece of history, albeit, you know, not something we really want to find. But yeah, nonetheless, a piece of history about this area, and it shows that they've been managing the wildlife around here for some time. Miles from that pin fire cartridge, and there's a really lovely bright signal over here in the long grass, obviously. Right, so I'm happy I pinpointed that into there. That's reading a 74 on the Manticore. Now, dare I say it, sounds very coiny. It's very bright, very consistent, very obvious. So it could be the first coin of the day. Let's go for a good easy plug in this grass. Yeah, it's actually really easy digging there. Still really bright, 72 to 75. Come on, beer coin, beer coin. Lucky, lucky me. Come on. Oh, have I not, Have I just got it in the sidewall still? Oh, I'm slightly off. My pinpointing was pants. Yeah, right there in the edge. Get the trusty tool out. Come on. Be a big chunky penny or something, I'd imagine. Copper penny, what was that? Did I see some green? No. Oh. Oh man. It's actually shiny and gold down here. But I don't expect for 1 minute it will be actually gold. That'd be ridiculous. No. Ah. Oh, you've got to see this. Let me take you in. So here we are. I'm in this hole. Look at this coming out of here. Oh, it's enough to give you a heart attack until you sort of start to realise it's just going to be a bottle top, isn't it? Oh, what an absolute sod. Yeah, this is looking like a bottle top. Please don't have a bottle attached to it. Have you got a bottle attached? Oh, I think you have. Oh, no. No, just part of it. Bit of glass on the bottom, and that's why you wear gloves, ladies and gentlemen. But that is a bottle top. Damn it. That's why it sounded so good. One piece of round metal, that's what the metal detector's looking for. It's saying dig me, and I have. Never mind. I know. This is Badger, and Badger loves belly rubs, don't you? You've joined us today as the hunt hound. Oh dear, I'm not gonna get any digging done if I'm belly rubbing. Right, you gonna let me crack on?
Yes, he's a good boy, he's a good boy, he's a good boy.
Here we are with Nick, who invited me out today onto this fabulous permission. Thanks for bringing us along.
That's
Nick,
right,
really appreciate it. And you've got a coin.
Yep, got a coin.
Looks like we've got a farthing here of George III. It was easier to see when it was wet, wasn't it? It's got the little bits at the, you know, the laurel leaves going round. I wonder if it's a William. Oh, I don't know now.
I think I could make out
George. Can you see the wording, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no, you're right there.
Sure, that's George.
George's on there. Yeah, so not a lot to look at, I'm afraid, guys, because it's a little sort of mushed up copper coin, but that's a 200-year-old farthing of George III, probably sort of 1816 or something along those lines. Well, let's hope we can find something shinier than that.
That's definitely. Well, at least it's the first coin of the day.
And how deep? We were looking in here about...
It was here.
Yeah, so we're looking about yay deep into the ground there. So, 200 years has given us nearly sort of two-thirds of a foot depth, isn't it? It's difficult to say we're going to find ancient stuff in this topsoil, but who knows? It's been ploughed in the past. Got ourselves a lovely little find in the hole down here. Real struggle. Really, really hard. Look at this. Really, really hard down there, but and I've just covered it over. But it's a complete piece of history down here. It's an old buckle, and it's still got the tiniest, weeniest little clasp on it, which I assume is the metal must have just corroded away over time. So it was this big chunky one that's just withered down to nothingness. It's absolutely awesome. It's a spectacle buckle, and it's probably sort of 200-300 years old. See what I mean? This clasp in the middle is wafer thin, absolutely teeny. There's no way that was going to keep your belt on. Absolutely not. I don't really want to move it too much because I feel like it will just break it, just touching it there. But there's nothing really on the back. It would have been a design under there, and when I clean it up, you might be able to see a bit more about it. So I think we'll leave that one for later. We'll do a full clean up on that one, and we'll have a little talk about that because that is awesome. So the sort of competition that me and Nick are having today, he's got that coin, had a couple of buttons. I think now with this buckle, I'm back in the game. I think I'm in the lead, unless he finds something decent by the end of this little chat with you guys. But yeah, that's great. Get in. I'm well happy. Well, this is certainly exciting. I'm staring at a massive, great, silver-coloured disc. Probably bigger than any coin in silver that I've ever seen before. So it's not going to be a blooming coin, is it? But maybe it is. Maybe it could be one of those absolutely massive crowns or something like that. I don't know. I'm leaning towards maybe one of those huge illegal buttons. But it's down here in the hole. Let's go and have a look. As we descend deep into this hole, you can see what I mean. It is big. Maybe it's not as big as I think it is. Could that be a coin? Could I be lucky enough? Let's get my little digging tool. See if we can prise gently underneath and around this. Yeah, I think that's got it free. Come on, be a coin. No, I think I just felt a shank underneath it. Dang! That is an absolutely enormous D-bag of a button. Ridiculous. Look at this. Oh, it's enough to give you a heart attack. That's why I call them illegal buttons. Big old pewter Tombax. I mean, it's in mint condition. It's probably one of the finest examples I've ever found. They give you a heart attack. Ah, what a bugger. Still, I'll take it. And that's button number 4. Looks like I'm into a coin down here. It's green, not the colour we're looking for. Yeah, green half penny. Gosh, not sure right now. There's a bit of detail on there. There might be enough to get an identification. That's what we're dealing with. Right, we go. Hang on. Is that the right angle suddenly? This might be a token, you know. Or is it? No, it's a George. Georges. Can't see any Roman numerals. Right, I'll stop faffing. I'll give it a clean up and I'll let you know what it is. Okay, so I've given this a clean up now and it's very clearly a George the II half penny. Now these, can I see the date on it? They range sort of mid 1700s. And you'll be able to see George there looking his profile to the left. And it'll be Georges and then the two Roman numerals to sort of top right, the 2 o'clock of the coin there. So if you have trouble identifying these, look for the profile looking to the left with Georges and the two Roman numerals, you'll know what you've got. And then on the back, very difficult to see, but there is Britannia there and the date would in theory be just below the strike right at the bottom there at the 6 p.m. But can't make that out, sadly. But there you go, that's a Georgian coin. That's going to be a good sort of couple hundred years old. I keep dropping it. But today, it was found in the ground. Well, I'll let you have a listen to this one before I get it out of the hole. I've dug the plug. 41-42. No matter what angle you hit it at. That's that consistency of signal that you need sometimes just to be really sure to dig. But that's a mid-tone on the manticore. It's getting really warm now. Whew. Let's see what we got. It's still deep. Gosh, I have to go down even more. 42, 43. What could it be? Could be a smaller coin, maybe. Be a hammered coin. Be nice. Definitely be needing a bit of silver today. Be rude not to. Silver Saxon. Now that would be even better. Something about Saxon stuff really grabs me. You can't still be. You're still in there. It's even deeper. It's lucky the digging's not too hard. Oh, there ain't a big bit of iron I've just caught there, is it? God, it feels like it might be. It is. No, it's not a big bit of iron. Oh my dear God. That's a huge, oh, an absolutely ginormous buckle. I assume off big old horse. Yeah, it's got shiny on it. A bit of the middle bits left, so yeah, I'm pretty confident it's a buckle. Wow, that was a beast. Well, no wonder it gave me a nice consistent signal. I think it's got like an aluminium front on it. The rest of it's probably iron. Oh well, not quite the Saxon penny I was hoping for, but it's still a find. Get in! There's a hammered. I got a hammered. You got to hear this. Hammered coin. How rubbish is that? That's a 13 on the Manticore. A 13. It's not in the best condition. We'll come to the hammer coin in a minute. That's part of the excitement here. Check this out. Probably slightly over from my initial hole. That's, it's jumping about a bit, but it's sort of low, sort of 10, 12. It's gone up to 19 there. Could that be a second hammered coin there? Let's dig it. Let's dig that. And then we'll come to this other one. One that we know that's definitely in the business. And it wasn't very deep. It really wasn't. And that was my fear. So everything was gone far too deep by now. Oh, there's a little. Better scan this. Doing everything the wrong way around now. Yeah, definitely a little signal in there, isn't there? Right. God, can you imagine two hammies right next to each other? That'll get me excited. Might get me in the realms of horde territory again. So it's in the side there. Just nearly walked away from this. Did not think that was worth digging, really, at 12, 14 on a manticore. Absolutely nuts. Right there in the corner. Cool, the first hole was easy to dig. I'm working for this one. Watch this just be a bit of chuff. Come on. Two hammers in the same hole, come on. Oh, I'm sure it was in there. There we go, it is out of the hole. And I can confirm it's a piece of metal. Oh dear, it's a piece of lead, I think. Yeah, a piece of flat lead, fine. Right. Excitement over, unless, shall we scan? Let's scan one more time, make sure there's nothing in there. Nope, I think we're good. So it's back to this initial hammered coin. So what have we got? Bit battered. Oh gosh, very battered. Looks like an Edward penny of some kind. Right, let's have a clean up and I'll show you what I've got. Well, here she is. Eddie halfpenny, I think, given the size. Little bit ratty on the side there, but as you can see on the good side, looks absolutely perfect, hasn't been clipped at all. And you can see Edward's little profile in there. Let's have a little flip. Whoop, come on, flipperoo. Right, there we are. And long cross, as you'd expect from an Edward. Yeah, not a lot else I can say that's great about that. Other than it's a hammered coin on pasture and it was a 12. Let's get that in our heads, guys. A 12 on a manticore. 12, I mean, manticores go up to 100. On a Nox, that would be what? Half that, 6, 4. So if you've got Noxes out there and you're not digging these low targets, stop. Just start digging them. If they're consistent, just get in there. If you've got to dig 100 bits of foil, it doesn't matter. Every now and then, you're going to get one of these. Just had a really interesting balloon of a button. Nice little details on the front there. But look at that. The whole thing would have been a big, round, domed beastie. I wonder who'd have been wearing that. I'd know they'd have been looking in the cat's pyjamas in it, though, because that is one trendy-looking button. I love it. Ooh, it's warmer today. I've just taken on board some liquids, had a little break. It's going quite well today. Lots of little things coming up. Nothing Saxon yet, but still got a couple of hours. So maybe it will happen. If you're enjoying this, guys, give me a thumbs up. Click the corner. Check out the last video uploaded. It's where I found this awesome silver coin that I never found before. So please do check that out. But I'm going to get back out there with my Manticore, right in the heart of the Saxon area now, where a Saxon coin came up just recently. So there's absolutely every chance that I will find one. And I have been waiting a long time to try and find one of those. So I really need to stop talking and get back digging. One more thing I do need to do though before I get back to digging, let's deal with this little situation down here.
Hello you, hello. Oh yes.
Bellies, let's not forget bellies now.
Oh, you chilling out, you enjoying today.
Oh yes you are.
Yes you are, you're a good boy. Right, you're giving me good luck today, Badger.
Bye bye bye. Well, I've never found one of these before, but I know exactly what it is. When I saw it, I was like, I can't believe it. Because they are much confused with spur rowels. But this is a pastry cutter. You can see the little wavy lines there, and it would have wheeled along the edges of pieces of pastry. I'm not sure how old this one is. This could be really flipping old. It's got that patina, that look to it. I think I'm going to get my toothbrush out and we'll have a little clean up of that. That's really nice. What a lovely little bit of domestic history. So I've just cleaned up this pastry cutter and what a delight. This is absolutely exceptional. I mean, it's like a museum quality item. I don't even know what to say. I'm taken aback by it. It's such an awesome thing. You can find hammered coins nearly most times you go out in Norfolk, and a lot of detectorists will tell you they are common things, but I've never found one of these. And I'm going to try and show you as best I can, but it still works. It still spins. And I hope you can see that. You could put a wooden handle back on this and use it on your pastry today. It is absolutely exceptional, and I wonder how old it is. I really needed to find out. So I think I'll do that now. Hello everyone, and welcome to the project section of this video. We're going to have a look at the pastry cutter. It turns out it's Victorian. Also, by the way, this is Dizzy. She won't leave me alone at the moment because she's not been very well and she's not allowed outside. She had a fang taken out, one of her teeth went wobbly, so she's been a bit needy. But anyway, the pastry cutter, yeah, Victorian, not so old, which kind of explains perhaps why it's in good condition. But I want to upcycle it and I want to put it back to how it would have looked, or at least as close as possible. It probably would have all been made of metal, so I can't really weld anything together, but I'm going to make something out of a wooden spoon of all things, give it a nice handle, and then it'll be suitable to go into the mini museum. You never know, it may even be usable. If it is, well, we'll see what happens. Let's do the upcycle and see how it goes. So here we go. I've got this old wooden spoon that I've used for many, many years. I'm going to repurpose it, chop a bit off the top and bottom, so this will form the handle for the pastry cutter. Right, so I've got the handle down to the size that I want. Now I need to drill a recess to house the business end of the pastry cutter. So I'm happy that that's nice and sanded flat. Now I've got to sand and contour the rest of the handle. So this might take a little while. Cue a fast forward. Mm-hmm. With all the sanding complete, I grabbed the old tin of varnish that we all have in our store cupboard, I think this is a teak one in colour, and grabbed a cloth and started to apply it. And I think it's starting to look really vintage. I thought that went brilliantly. What do you think, Diz? She's been a nightmare while I've been filming. What do you think of the, I don't know if she cares about the pastry cutter, but I think that's come out great as a museum, you know, piece as it were, to put in my little mini museum. I think that's awesome, and I hope I can do something like that with some other finds if it's sort of suitable to them. But let's go a little bit further. Should we make some mince pies? Yeah, I think we should make some mince pies actually, because although this video, the hunter part of it, was filmed back in the summer before I had a little break from YouTube, it's now late November and it's time to make mince pies, and of course this pastry cutter is the perfect excuse to do that. However, I'm no baker. I'll quite happily make savoury stuff all day long, but this is all new to me. So I've bought some ready-made shortcut pastry. I've got my dish. I've got some mince filling as well, but that's in the fridge. I've got a little shaper, I'll come to that in a bit, and I've got some milk as well to go on there, and a little brushy thing to put it on there. So I think I've got everything I need. All right, let's roll this out. It's not sticking. Oh God, no, it is sticking. Sticking a bit there. Okay. Oh gosh, drama before I've even begun. Some of it looks better over there than it does there. Will that matter? Probably not. Add to the flavour, won't it? I'm sure it'll all squish together. So, I bet the bakers amongst you will go, this pastry cutter is not meant for doing mince pies. And I'm sure you're right, but I just want to use it and I want to make something that's seasonal and that I can take in to work and share with everyone as well. So mince pies it is. Yeah, that's just about kind of rolled out. It's a bit rough. Oh dear, yeah, that side's a bit. What can you do, eh? Tis what it is. So this doodah, this little lid, is bigger. I think it's off a Bisto gravy. Other gravies are available. It's just about bigger than my little circles there on my tray. So plan is, cut out some circles, then go round with my cutter to give it the wavy edge. Well, it cuts pastry. It's difficult going around like that. I'm sure if you're doing, I don't know, pasties or something, it's probably more useful. Those of you that cook are probably absolutely screaming at the screen. Right, so they're all now in their new homes. I was told by Mary Berry off of the internet and cooking that you should get a fork and prick the bottoms of the pies. It's all going ever so well. I best get the oven on. The oven should be 180 degrees on a fan assisted oven. So I've got this much pastry left. This is short crust pastry, so I figure I need to make some tops for my 12 mince pies. I haven't got a rolling pin because I don't do this sort of stuff, but I have found my I've got a little bamboo container here, which hopefully that will work for me. So I want to roll this out, I guess. Right, my little lids are done. They're a little bit too small, but they'll expand on that, won't they? So time to get my filling. Lovely old job. Oh, yes, decent. Spiced brandy. Where's my little wooden spoon? Ah, here we go. Been waiting for a reason to use this little wooden spoon for a long time. Right, so let's fill up these little delights. If only I'd have had a slightly bigger cutter. Got that little bit of dough left. Let me make something with that and then these can go in the oven. It's come to me, it's an utter masterstroke. But I've got circles on there, haven't I? And what do they look like? Metal detecting coils. Of course they do. So I'm just going to add a shaft to each one. Actually look like little mini pastry cutters now. All milked up. Now let's get them in the oven. I'm absolutely chuffed with them. That's the first time I've ever made mince pies. They look awesome. I can't wait to munch on them. I'm going to take them into work, share them with the guys. I wish I had some caster sugar to throw over it, make it look really Christmassy, but other than that, they're spot on. So happy. I hope you enjoyed that, guys. I hope you have a great Christmas when it gets there. Can afford to get excited here because down in the hole is a very dark grey disc, and silver goes that colour in the ground. I don't know what to say really. The excitement, I want to hold on to it. You want to build it into your metal detecting career, because actually once you find out what it is, most of the time it's just a button and it ruins it all for you. But where's my little trowel? Let's go in this hole. Hopefully you can see it. There we go, I've got Nick on the camera. Lovely little thing going on here, and there looks to be some details. So all going well, we've got ourselves something, maybe a big hammered, maybe a big milled silver. Got to be super duper careful. Already covering it up again. Oh, it's a stone right next to it. Oh, okay. Got to be so gentle with these things. I think that's flicked up now. Here we go, guys. No shank on the back, and actually it's not looking silver anymore, is it? Looking more like a copper coin. How did that happen so quickly? It went from silver to copper, and that's what it is. It's a George III half penny. Oh, how did that happen? Can you even believe that? Can you even believe that? Me and Nick both looked at it and thought, yeah, that's going to be a big silver coin. But I'm not disappointed. That's awesome. It's still an old coin, but gosh, why isn't it silver? Why? Monster musket ball. Got to be a brown bess. Absolutely ginormous. Look at the size of that thing. What a lump. Don't find many that big. My gosh. No Saxon for me. Such a shame, but found so many awesome things from such a small area. I've barely done, if I've done an acre, it'd be amazing. So productive, it's unreal. And Nick's had a fair few bits as well, and we'll pop over there and check on his finds as well, see what he's got. But guys, just wanted to quickly say as well, check out new caps. They're now available, see the link below, you can get them direct from me, and even have them personalized with your name on the back. So there you go, get yourself a fit G cap now. Here's Nick, let's go and see what he's found. Right, that's me all done for the day. Thank you ever so much, Nick, for inviting me along.
That's all right, pleasure. Not a problem
really,
at all.
Really, really kind of you. I've had such a good day and I haven't been out in ages, so I really needed to get out.
Yeah, get rid of the cobwebs.
Yeah. Absolutely. I think you all know, it's like, we're all waiting for harvest and you've heard the combines rolling, haven't you?
Yeah. Hoping and praying that we don't get any rain and they combine soon.
They are on the way, guys. So, you know, everyone who's got, you're lucky enough to have farm permissions, it's this time, isn't it? We're all going to get excited and get out there. But it's for Saxon land. We were hoping for a bit of Saxon today. You found a little bit of potentially Saxon pottery.
Saxon pottery, yeah, a little pretty, shard.
Yeah, that's something, isn't it? So that was kind of a little taster of what there. The hammered came up, the buckle, you had a few coins as well. What stood out? I can't forget.
The pastry cutter. That's your it. Pastry cutter was stunning.
The pastry cutter?
Yeah, never seen one in that condition before.
Who would have thought? Yeah, absolutely. It's just come out of the ground, like, you know, with a bit of patina on it, but like it was made yesterday. So hopefully we know a bit more about it now, because I promised I'd have a little chat about that earlier in the video. But cool. Anyway, I'll stop rabbiting on. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.
Bye.